एडिशन ऑफ इंटीजर्स। रूल्स फॉर एडिंग इंटीजर्स। फर्स्ट रूल, फॉर एडिशन ऑफ टू पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स और नंबर्स, वी सिंपली एड बोथ द इंटीजर्स एंड पुट पॉजिटिव साइन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 6 + 2 इज इक्वल टू 8। सी हियर, इन दिस नंबर लाइन वी शुड मूव फ्रॉम 0 to 6। Now we should move in the right direction, because in this example our next number is +2, means we have to move in right direction only. Now which number we have to take? This is 6 + 2. We have to move from 6 by 2 units, 6 to 7 and 7 to 8. Now we have reached number 8. This is the answer. 6 + 2 is equal to 8. Rule number 2. For addition of two negative integers. Here also we should simply add the integers and we have to put negative sign. For example, -4 + -3. We should add the numbers. -4 + -3 = 7. Now put the negative sign, that is -7. In this number line, from 0 to left side, -4 is here. We should add -3. From -4, we should move in the left direction. From -4, we have to move 3 numbers in the left direction. That is -5, -6, -7. We reached the number -7. This is the answer. Therefore, -4 + -3 = -7. Rule number 3. When a positive and a negative integer are added, we have to subtract the numbers and put the sign of the greater number. For example, -9 + 3. We have to subtract the numbers, which will give us 6. And now we should put the greater number sign. Here the greater number is -9. Therefore the result is -6. Look at this number line. From -9, we should move to 3 places in the right direction. From -9 to -8, -7, -6. We reached here, -6. This is our answer. So, -9 + 3 = -6. Solving these examples on the number line is easy and fun, isn't it? Properties of addition of integers. There are some properties for addition that will help make problems easier to solve. First one is closure property. When we add two integers, the sum is always an integer. In general, for any two integers a and b, a plus b is an integer. For example, 20 + 10 = 30. Result is an integer. Second one is 3 + -4 = -1. Result is an integer. Since addition of integers gives integers, we say integers are closed under addition. Second one is commutative property. The commutative property of addition states that numbers can be added in any order to get the same sum or result. In general, for any two integers, a and b, a + b = b + a. For example, 7 + 3 = 10. Or change the order, 3 + 7 = 10. Even if we interchange the order, we get the same answer. Another example, 9 - -10 = -1. Or -10 + 9 = -1. Addition is commutative for integers. Associative property. Associative property of addition states that when you add three or more numbers, you can group them in any order and the sum will be the same. In general, for any three integers a, b and c, a plus inside the bracket b plus c is equal to in the bracket a plus b plus c. For example, 8 plus in the bracket 3 plus 4 is equal to in the bracket 8 plus 3 plus 4. Here 8 plus 7 is equal to 15. Here 11 plus 4 is equal to 15. Both the case we get the same result. One more example. Minus 5 plus in the bracket minus 2 plus in the bracket minus 4 is equal to in the bracket minus 5 plus minus 2 plus minus 4. Here minus 5 plus inside the bracket minus 6 is equal to minus 11. Here minus 7 plus inside the bracket minus 4 is equal to minus 11. So addition is associative for integers. Distributive property. Distributive property of multiplication over addition. The distributive property states that multiplying a sum by a number gives the same result as multiplying each addend by the number and then adding the products together. In general, for any three integers a, b and c, a into in the bracket b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. For example, 3 into in the bracket 2 plus plus 4 is equal to 3 into 2 plus 3 into 4. Here 3 into 6 is equal to 18. Here 6 plus 12 is equal to 18. Both expressions give the same result. Example 2. Minus 2 in the bracket 4 plus 3 is equal to minus 2 into 4 plus minus 2 into 3. Here minus 2 into 7 is equal to minus 14. Here minus 8 plus in the bracket minus 6 is equal to minus 14. Here also we get the same result, right? So addition is distributive for integers. Next one is the additive identity. This property says that if you add an integer to 0 or add 0 to an integer, then you get the same integer. The number 0 is known as the additive identity. For any integer a, a plus 0 is equal to 0 plus a is equal to a. For example, 15 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus 15 is equal to 15 only. Another example, 160 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus 160 is equal to 160 only. So integer 0 is the identity under addition. Next one is additive inverse property. The additive inverse property tells us to simply take a number and add its opposite. So we get 0. For example, 5 plus inside the bracket minus 5 is equal to 0. The additive inverse of plus 5 is minus 5 because plus 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. One more example. 120 plus in the bracket minus 120 is equal to 0. Without mathematics, there is nothing you can do. Everything around you is mathematics. Everything around you is numbers. Thanks for watching.